Hi, I'm Daniel. I'm part of the materials team at SCS, and today I'm going to guide you through the first steps in the application of thermal history technology, gritblasting and painting.
When a component arrives at SCS, we should prepare the surface of interest before applying the thermal history paint. Any surface contaminant will result in a poor surface adhesion of the thermal history paint. In the case of this automotive component, the surface of interest is covered in grease and dirt, and it should be clean. To remove these contaminants, we grit blast the surface using aerospace grade grit, which is propelled against the surface using compressed air. Alumina grit is used, providing an even surface roughness, which leads to a good adhesion for the paint. The surface is then cleaned after the grit blasting process and before applying the paint. The second step is painting. Unlike other thermal measurement paints, SCS products do not contain any toxic materials. Once the component has been grit blasted, the thermal history paint is applied in our spray booth. To guarantee a good atomization of the paint, we use a high volume, low pressure spray gun. The application is done in thin layers, allowing drying between layers and checking the dry thickness after several passes. The total dry thickness is between 25 and 30 microns. Thermal history paint should be dried in ambient conditions and then heat treated to ensure that the material adheres to the substrate surface. Once the paint is dried and heat treated, it is ready for operation.